What does it look like I'm doing? Perhaps I'm checking my email. Perhaps I'm just looking at a website on the internet. Well, in actual fact, what I'm using is a PinePhone, and I'm cracking Wi-Fi networks using Wifite on this phone. I can use various applications, Mon in G, or in this example, Wifite, to discover Wi-Fi networks and then crack Wi-Fi networks using this PinePhone. Now, this video is for educational purposes only. The Wi-Fi network that I'm going to be attacking is this Wi-Fi network behind me. I own the infrastructure. I own this phone. I just want to demonstrate that a phone such as this running Linux can run applications such as Wifite and others to crack Wi-Fi networks. Now, in this video, I'm showing you how to set up the phone from scratch. So from unboxing to being able to do this. So if you're not interested, for example, in seeing the unboxing and you just want to see the software that needs to be installed to get this to work, then use the timestamps below. I'll open the device. Very simple packaging on this device. Takes a bit of effort to open the box. There we go. So PinePhone, instruction manual, cover, the actual phone itself. That's broken, which is interesting. Got a cable. So, Linux phone.
Nice.
Now we're told in the instructions that we have to open this up, pry this open with our fingers or something else. Okay, there we go. Got to take the battery out. So I got to take this plastic off the battery. So I'll remove that. And I should be able to plug in the battery now. My main objective here is to get it booted with Linux and then to see if I can get a Wi-Fi adapter connected to this or do other things in Linux that you can't necessarily do on an Android phone unless you root it. Okay, you can see it's booting up. Welcome screen appears. Okay, so I'm in the UK. So I'll specify London as my time zone. It's trying to find Wi-Fi network, so I'll connect it to a Wi-Fi network. And I'll press connect. And there you go, I've got Linux running on my phone. Most important thing, because this is Linux, is I want to open up a terminal. So on the phone, I could use a command such as IP address to see the IP address of the phone. It's got an address of 192.168.30.18. So from my Mac, I'm going to SSH to that IP address, 192.168.30.18. And I can put in my password. And as you can see there, I'm connected to Manjaro ARM. Okay, so now that I've shown you the initial configuration of the phone, let's look at the software that needs to be installed to get Wifite working. Now, you don't have to use Wifite. You could use Mon in G. Installing Wifite, however, is good because it installs a whole bunch of extra tools. Like as an example, ifconfig doesn't work out of the box on this phone. iwconfig doesn't work. It's not installed on the default operating system. So what I've done is I've put a list of commands below, and I'll demonstrate them here, that shows you how to set this up. So the first thing I did was install openssh so that I could SSH to the phone. This phone is running Linux. You could install different versions of Linux. But in this case, because we're using Manjaro, we're going to use these commands to install openssh. So sudo pacman -s openssh to install openssh. We're going to use sudo systemctl enable SSH service to enable the service. We're going to start the service, and then you can verify it using this command. So I've used those commands previously to get SSH running on this phone. So if I just type the verify command, put my password in, you can see that the service is running. And I just use Q to quit there. So I've already SSH'd to the phone. And what I can do is use this command to update packages. So sudo pacman -s yu. It's checked if everything's up to date. As you can see, nothing needs to be installed. and then I can install Wifite. So I'll clear the screen and I'll paste that command in. Now, I'm going to reinstall Wifite here. Actually, what happens when you do this for the first time is it's not just going to install Wifite, it's going to install a whole bunch of other packages. It's going to install the software required to run commands such as ifconfig, iwconfig, amonng, other commands. So as an example, amonng works here because when you install Wifite, it actually installs that for you as a prerequisite. Makes it much easier than trying to install all the packages. So I'd recommend installing Wifite even if you didn't want to use the Wifite application because it installs a whole bunch of other necessary stuff. For Wifite to work, you need to install other software such as Wireshark. So in this example, I won't reinstall Wireshark, but you've got to install Wireshark, you've got to install HCX tools, you've got to install HCX dump tool, you've got to install Reaver, you've got to install CowPaddy. If you don't install that software, it's not going to work properly. Wifite also requires Pirate. So to install that, you need to install GCC, then you need to install Git, then you need to clone the Pirate software from GitHub. You need to go into the Pirate directory, set it up with a clean install, build it, and then install it. Now, if Python is not installed, you'll have to install Python as well. So if I look at my history, and then I grep for Python, this is the command that I used to install Python version 2. So I'll add that there. You need to have Python 2 with this version of Wifite. So make sure that you install Python 2, and then you can use Python to install the Pirate software. Now the dictionary is installed in this directory. So if you want to look at the dictionary, the probable dictionary, the one that's used by default, that is the dictionary of passwords that are used. You could use a different dictionary if you wanted to. So you could use RockU as an example, but that's the one that's used by default, and that's why I set this password to Spider-Man.
You're the Spider-Man.
I'm not.
Because by default, Spider-Man is in the list of probable passwords and a whole bunch of other Spider-Man iterations. And then I'll type the command sudo wifite to run the Wifite hacking tool directly on the phone. Now, we're told that there are two Wi-Fi adapters, WLAN 0 and WLAN 1. Here's a RT2800 USB. Now I'm SSHing from my Mac to the phone. This is the Wi-Fi adapter that I'm gonna use to attack the Wi-Fi network. So I'm gonna use 2 as an option here. It's enabling monitor mode on the Wi-Fi adapter. You need to use a Wi-Fi adapter that supports monitor mode. This one does supports both monitor and injection mode. And what you'll notice there is it's picked up a bunch of Wi-Fi networks. Now I'll press Control C to stop the application searching for Wi-Fi devices. As you can see here, this TP-Link network has two clients connected to it. So this little network has two clients. One of them is the Windows laptop over here. If I look at the Windows settings, you can see that it's connected to that network. The other device should be this phone. So if I go to the Wi-Fi settings on this phone, it's also connected to the same Wi-Fi network. And what that allows me to do is it allows me to kick off clients and capture the handshake if necessary. So what I'm going to do is select one to attack that Wi-Fi network. And as you can see, it's now running a pixie dust attack. Various attacks can be run. This one will take about 5 minutes, and then it's going to try a null pin attack. In this case, Reaver stopped the process. It's then going to try a WPS pin attack. That was locked by the access point, so that failed. It's going to try a PMKID attack. In this example, I'm going to stop that as well and press C to continue. And what it's going to try and do now is try and capture the handshake. It's already done that. And then now what it's trying to do is it's trying to crack the password. Okay, so there you go. It captured the handshake and then it broke the Wi-Fi password. Now in this example, it's using the wordless probable text file, and the password that I configured on this Wi-Fi network is Spider-Man.
No, I'm not Spider-Man.
I mean, I've been watching you for like a while now. It's kind of obvious.
That's a very easy one to crack. Hopefully, you're not using a password like that on your Wi-Fi network. May this be a warning to you that someone could use a phone like this and a little Wi-Fi adapter, and they could capture the handshake between your client devices and your access point, and then crack that. Now, they're probably not going to do it this way. They're probably going to use a GPU or something else if your password is very strong. If I type ls here, there's a directory called hs. If I go into that directory and type ls, there is the handshake that was captured between the TP-Link access point and the clients in this network. I was able to capture the handshake. I could have captured that from the PC or the phone. It just depends which one the application grabs first. And then I could take that capture file and then copy it to a computer with a GPU. I've linked a video below where I show you how to crack Wi-Fi passwords using GPUs. Make sure that you use better passwords than Spider-Man. Make sure that you use good passwords in your network. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. I showed you how to use a phone, in this case, a PinePhone, to hack a Wi-Fi network. In this case, a Wi-Fi network using WPA2. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Please like this video and click on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.